This is Kugan Cassius for IFL TV. We're in the Mercure Hotel here in Sheffield. With me, I have professional boxer Paul Butlin, who faces Anthony Joshua tomorrow night. You all right, Paul?
Yeah, bang on, mate.
Oh, yeah. At the press conference the other day, because a couple of people mentioned to me, Anthony Joshua mentioned it to me as well, your reference to him as a kid. I think it was slightly taken out of context. You probably didn't mean it in the way that some people are insinuating you meant it.
Yeah, I don't understand all that. I call everyone a kid. Anyone younger than me is a kid. And I'm 37, he's 24. Is he 23, 24?
Yeah, roughly.
So they got a member out, so to me, he's a kid.
Yeah.
So that's what I was saying, not that he's a kid, he's out of his depth or anything like that. He's just a kid to me.
Yeah.
He's younger, so that's it, basically.
Yeah, to be honest, you mentioned that, Anthony Joshua mentioned that today, and I said it would probably have been in that context,
yeah,
rather than to demean someone as a...
Yeah, you're a kid, you know what I mean?
Yeah, boy, yeah, I'm off sort, yeah, of thing, yeah. But you've got a task tomorrow. Like I said, a lot of hype around Anthony Joshua, as we all know.
Yeah.
It was for his first fight. There's going to be for this fight as well. So,
yeah.
How do you look at all that?
That comes parcel of the game, doesn't it? I mean, he's won the gold medal. So I think it's brave what Matchroom are doing, actually, matching him. But I think they have to. They're going to put a lot of money into him. Sky put a lot of money in, and they want to see good results, really. Mm. They don't want to see another Audley Harrison where he's fighting bums in his first 20 fights. He's won a gold medal. Top of his game as an amateur in the world, so they want to see him top of the game as a pro, and that's what they're doing with him, I think, which is a good choice. That's what people want.
For people who don't know, I mean, you've fought just about everyone in British boxing, haven't you? You've had it with them all, haven't you? Chisora,
yeah,
the lot, so.
Yeah, definitely.
Who's been your toughest fight to date?
Definitely Jonathan Banks.
Mm.
Just elusive on his feet, very fast, he can bang as well. So he's probably, yeah, definitely. A lot of my other fights I've overtook at like 3 days' notice, 24 hours' notice. And that's half the problem with this. I've got no excuses, I've had plenty of time. So let's see what he's got and then I'll tell you after.
Yeah, it'd be good to talk to you afterwards and you can tell me how he ranks alongside the rest.
It's common sense, he's a big, tall lad, long jab. Mm. So if I stay off him, which he's hoping I'll do, he'll just box me off or take me out. So I've just got to get into him.
What do you say to them people that think this is going to be an early night for Anthony Joshua tomorrow?
Nah, definitely not. My defence is too tight. And like I say, I've had plenty of notice. I've had 10 weeks.
Mm.
So if he does stop me, then you know what? Fair play to the kid. I'll take me off to him.
Yeah. How's your training camp gone leading up to this? All right? Standard?
Wicked. That's... No. Standard, me training myself, believe it or not.
Yeah.
So I've had a great trainer. Michael Robinson's helped me out this time doing pads and stuff. My sponsors helped me out a lot. I mean, cardio-wise, I get up at 5 o'clock and I do the runs, I do everything like a true pro. Not your typical lad that will just get up and just get the fight and train in the gym and do it that way. I do everything like I should, so.
Alright, well, like I said, say wish you the best of luck, the same as we wish anyone the best of luck in the fight. Well, you're both going in there to do your trade, so.
Like I said to you, I mean, friend at the end, you got to give it the way and you got to give it when you fight. That's part of the game. And then friend at the end, and he's a decent lad anyway. He hasn't said one bad word and I've looked as well. He's a nice lad, so that's good.
It was a bit of an overdue stare at the weigh-in today when it was going on for a little while.
Yeah, I did think about pushing him then. I thought, nah. I get a bit of a bollock in there, so I left it. I was going to put my forehead on his, but I couldn't reach it. So that's another thing that went out the window.
But I mean, Anthony's in the mentality that anyone who fights at this stage of his career is, you're going to want to beat him like anyone else is going to want to beat him, just because, not just because he's Anthony Joshua, but just because that's what you do.
It's a big win for me. If I win this, it's massive for me.
Yeah,
I could just ruin the party. So to me, I'll give 100%. It's a big fight for me. I'm not just turning up. That's what people think.
Yeah.
Because I've got more losses than wins. People think I'll just turn up and get filled in, but I won't. I'll go there to fight, and that's what the game's about. So.
That's it. All right. Paul, listen, thank you very much for talking to IFL TV, and wish you the best of luck, and we'll see what happens tomorrow.
Yeah, definitely. Cheers,
all
mate.
All right, Kugan Cassius here with Paul Butlin. Thank you very much.